And we all, with unveiled face, behold as in a mirror the glory of the Lord. And we're being transformed from glory to glory into the image of Christ, as by the Spirit of the Lord. Welcome to Mount of Transfiguration. Right behind me, you can see the mountain where Jesus took his disciples, Peter, James, and John. And on top of that mountain, he met with Moses and Elijah. And there he revealed his glory to them. The Apostle John wrote and he said, "We beheld his glory, full of grace and truth." On this episode of The Promise, we want to be teaching about the glory of the Holy Spirit and how God wants to reveal His nature, His heart to you through His glory, and how through His glory we are transformed from glory to glory into the image of God. In every episode of this series, we're coming to you from a different location in the land of Israel with a different teaching about the Holy Spirit, each one about a different aspect of the person of the Holy Spirit. We're also going to be showing what God is doing around the world in different nations and how He is covering the earth with the knowledge of His glory. If you want to see every episode, you can go to our website, holyspirit.tv. Before we begin with this teaching, we're going to go and show you the power of God from among the nations, what God is doing in different nations around the world.
Está en nosotros el anhelar ser santo. El desear decir, Señor, yo no quiero amar al mundo y las cosas de este mundo. Yo te quiero amar a ti. Yo no quiero seguir a este mundo y las cosas de este mundo. Yo te quiero seguir a ti porque la presencia de tu Espíritu vale más que todo lo que este mundo me pueda ofrecer. Si no hay un genuino arrepentimiento en tu corazón, en tu vida, no esperes que Dios te dé el fuego de su Espíritu Santo. Tiene que haber un deseo y un anhelo de decirle, Señor, yo quiero tomar una decisión de abandonar el pecado para seguir a Jesucristo. El arrepentimiento no significa que, Señor, yo confieso mi pecado y después sigo de la misma manera viviendo que antes. El arrepentimiento te lleva a producir fruto digno de arrepentimiento, que habla de un cambio de tu manera de vivir. Las buenas noticias son estas: que Dios fue tan grande su amor para con nosotros, en que siendo aún pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros. Las buenas noticias es que porque de tal manera amó Dios a este mundo, que dio a su Hijo unigénito para que todo aquel que en Él crea no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna. Juan el Bautista bautizaba en agua para arrepentimiento, pero habla que Jesús nos iba a sumergir en el Espíritu Santo y fuego. Cuando Dios te bautiza con fuego, Él derrama su amor sobre tu corazón. Romanos 5:5 dice: la esperanza no avergüenza, porque el amor de Dios ha sido derramado en nuestros corazones por el Espíritu Santo que nos fue dado. Y esto transforma tu vida. Esto es lo que cautiva tu corazón. Desde Chihuahua, México, la juventud de México le pertenece a Jesucristo.
it is to see that the knowledge of the glory of God is covering the earth as the waters cover the sea. We are ascending at this moment the Mount of Transfiguration. We're going to the place where Jesus revealed his glory to his disciples. On top of this mountain, the Bible says that Jesus showed them and God manifested his glory to Peter, James, and John. Also, on top of this mountain, Jesus met with Moses and Elijah. It is wonderful to be in this place and to be able to come to you from right here with the teaching about how you can also experience his glory in your life. It is the glory of God what transforms us into the image of Christ. We all have things in our lives that we need to change. And we all desire to be more and more like Jesus. And we can only be transformed when we are exposed to the glory of God. The Bible also says that God supplies all of our needs according to his riches in glory. It's in the glory of God where God supplies our needs. The Bible also says that in his glory, he reveals to us his heart, his essence, his nature, his character, his name. In his glory, God proclaims his name, and in his glory, God shows us who he truly is. There was another man in history. His name was Moses. And the Bible says that he had a relationship with God, a very intimate relationship with God. He spoke to God face to face like you would speak to a friend. On one instance, Moses, his desire was to get to know the Lord. His desire was to know his ways. So he told the Lord, "Show me your ways that I may know you and that I might find favor before your eyes." And the Bible says that the Lord said to Moses, "My presence will go with you and I will give you rest." God was going to give Moses his presence to show him his ways. He had already received the law, but now his presence was going to guide them. His presence was going to lead him. But not only that, Moses said to the Lord, "Lord, please show me your glory." Moses not only wanted to have the law of the Lord, he not only wanted his presence to guide him, to lead them, he not only wanted to be led by the Spirit of the Lord, he also wanted to behold the glory of God. Because he knew that if he was able to get a glimpse of the glory of the Lord, his life was going to be transformed forever. He knew he was going to encounter the heart and the emotions of God. So the Lord said to Moses, "Because you found favor before my eyes," he told him, "go up the Mount Sinai." He gave him instructions to go on top of another mountain, to ascend another mountain, and that on top of that mountain, he was going to find a rock and that he was going to stand on that rock. And then he gave him instructions of what he needed to do in order to behold the glory of the Lord. In the same way, if we want to behold the glory of God, we must be willing also to draw near to God. The scriptures say, "Draw near to me and I will draw near to you." If we want to see his glory, we must ascend the hill of the Lord. The Bible asks a question, who would ascend? Who would ascend the hill of the Lord? And who will stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul to an idol, he will receive blessings from the Lord. How amazing it is to know that you and I today can draw near to God because of what Jesus did for us on the cross. None of us has clean hands or a pure heart. Therefore, none of us can draw near to God. But because of the sacrifice of Jesus, today you and I can have clean hands and a pure heart. The Bible says, "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see the Lord." When the Lord gives you a pure heart, you're able to behold him for who he is. In the generation of Moses, only he went up the mountain. The children of Israel did not want to go up the mountain. They were afraid, the Bible says, of the fire that was on top of the mountain. They were afraid, therefore, they did not want to ascend the mountain. In the generation of Jesus, only three went up the mountain: Peter, James, and John. But in our generation, the Bible says, we all can go up to his mountain. The Bible says that this is the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, O God of Jacob. So I want to encourage you today to draw near to the Lord, and he promises to draw near to you. If we want his glory to descend, we must ascend. We must lift up our soul to him and not to an idol. We must lift up our soul to the Lord if we want to behold his glory. From right here, from the side of the Mount of Transfiguration, we want to show you another nation and how God manifested his glory, his love, his goodness, his power.
If my people,
se o meu povo,
who are known by my
que se chama pelo meu nome,
would humble themselves,
se humilhar,
would pray,
e orar,
would seek my face,
buscar a minha face,
would turn from their wicked ways,
e se arrepender dos seus maus caminhos,
I will answer from heaven,
então eu ouvirei dos céus,
and I will heal their land,
e eu perdoarei seus pecados e sararei a sua terra. I felt as the Lord was touching me and healing my breathing, and it was immediately, it was tremendous. I had a knot here in my breast for 3 years. I felt like energy going through my body, and then I can't feel it anymore. It's gone. I'm completely healed. Sendo. No, no, nothing. I couldn't even bow, not even wash my feet. I was feeling a lot of pain. It was terrible.
Glória a Deus.
I was healed. Woo! Glória a Deus. Glory be to God.
For you to praise him and to give, you must also offer him your life.
Se não é o bastante apenas oferecer sacrifício de louvor, você precisa oferecer tudo, tudo que você tem, a sua vida.
He wants you.
Ele quer você.
He wants all of you.
Ele quer tudo de você.
If you believe in Jesus,
se você crê em Jesus,
you will live forever.
Você viverá para sempre.
Do you believe
this? Você crê nisso?
In Belo Horizonte, Brazil, Jesus Christ is Lord. Let revival come.
How awesome it is to see how God is manifesting his glory in our generation. How lives around the world are being transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit. We continue from right here, from the top of Mount of Transfiguration. On the top of this mountain, the Bible tells us that Jesus revealed his glory to his disciples. And he met with Elijah and with Moses on top of this mountain. And the Bible says that there was a cloud that descended here in this place. And there was an audible voice that was heard. This is my beloved son. Hear him. How wonderful it is to see that Jesus, even today, he desires to reveal his glory to us. He desires to reveal his glory to you. Right there where you are, he desires to make his goodness pass before your eyes. Moses had a desire to encounter the glory of God. And God told him that he must ascend the hill of the Lord. He must ascend the mountain. He must ascend the Mount Sinai. And on top of the mountain, he was going to find a rock. And then the second thing he told him to do, that he must stand on the rock. That rock represents Jesus Christ. If we want to behold the glory of God, we must make Jesus the foundation of our lives. We must trust in Jesus. For he said, there is no other way to the Father. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. Like that beautiful hymn says, on Christ, the solid rock, I stand. And Moses stood on the rock, and he waited and waited for the glory of God to be manifested to him. And then God took Moses and he hit him. He hit him in the cleft of a rock. And the Bible says that the Lord descended in a cloud, and he made his goodness pass before him, and he proclaimed his name to Moses. He revealed who he was. He revealed his heart, his nature, his emotion. He revealed himself to Moses. And when Moses encountered the glory of God, the Bible said that he made haste and he bowed down and worshiped the Lord and said, Lord, forgive our iniquities and forgive our sins. In the same way, when we make a decision to trust in Jesus, the Bible says that God hides us in his presence. He hides us in the Spirit. And only then are we able to behold his glory. Only then are we able to see his goodness, when we are hidden in Christ. Jesus said, abide in me, and I will abide in you. And then the Lord shows us his heart, his emotion, his feeling, his character, his nature. As we are hidden in his presence, he makes his goodness pass before our eyes, and he declares to us personally his name. And we encounter, when we encounter his glory, the response of our hearts is worship. We become worshipers of the Lord in spirit and in truth. And when his goodness is revealed to us, that is when we make a decision to turn away from our sins and we trust in Jesus. Not because we are afraid of him, but because we've had a revelation of his heart, of his goodness, of his love for us, we make a decision to turn away from our sins and to follow Jesus for the rest of our lives. The Bible says that Moses encountered the Lord, desired to know the Lord, desired to know his ways. And because of that, God made a covenant with him that he was going to do wonders through his life like there had never been seen before in history. In the same way, when you desire to see his glory, God promises you that he will do wonders through your life. From right here, from the top of the Mount of Transfiguration, where God revealed his glory to his disciples, and where God wants to reveal his glory to you, we're going to see how the power of the Holy Spirit transformed so many lives, and how God manifested his glory among the nations. That was upon Jesus.
Que estaba sobre Jesús.
The same Holy Spirit,
el mismo Espíritu Santo,
comes in you,
viene hacia ti,
and seals you,
y dentro de ti te sella.
And he gives testimony to your spirit that you are a son of God.
Y da testimonio a tu espíritu que eres hijo de Dios.
The Holy Spirit.
El Espíritu Santo.
The greatest of all gifts that Jesus could have given you.
El regalo más grande que Jesús te pudiese haber dado.
Comes to dwell inside of you.
Viene a morar dentro de ti.
And he will never leave you.
Y él nunca te dejará.
And he will never forsake you.
Y él nunca te abandonará.
Holy Spirit, burn like a fire. Oh, consume me, hearing your presence. Lord, I surrender to your glory, for your glory.
It's something unbelievable, something like a heat of wind just going to you.
For years I've been battling with depression, anxiety. I felt a heat and I felt a peace. Just saying it's done.
Today I came back to the Lord like the prodigal son came back. I felt it vibrating that I'm feeling right now.
I was begging God to help me out of the dark hole. I saw a light. It felt wonderful. I felt the love I've never felt before.
He tried to make me kill myself.
You feel free?
Yes. So much anger and anxiety in me. I had never felt anything like this. I have never felt so loved in my life.
You tell me who else loves like Jesus.
Tú dime quién más ama como Jesús.
Who else demonstrated his love for you and for me by giving himself on the cross?
¿Quién más demostró su amor por ti y por mí al darse voluntariamente en la cruz?
Who was wounded? For your transgressions.
Por tus transgresiones.
Who was bruised for your iniquities?
Molido por tus iniquidades.
Only Jesus.
Solo Jesús.
Only Jesus.
Solo Jesús.
From Little Rock, Arkansas, the youth of the United States belong to Jesus.
It's amazing to see the goodness of God being manifested to so many lives around the world through the power of the Holy Spirit. From right here, from the top of the Mount of Transfiguration, we want to pray with you if you want to encounter the glory of God, if you want to encounter His goodness and you want to know the heart of God. I want to encourage you, first of all, to make a decision to stand on the rock, to trust in Jesus Christ and to give Him your life. If you want to make this decision and if you want His glory to be revealed to you, right there where you are, simply close your eyes and pray this prayer with me. Say, Jesus, I make a decision today to draw near to you, and I ask you, Lord, to give me a pure heart, give me a clean heart. I make a decision to turn away from my sins, and I place my trust in you. Jesus, I want to know your ways. I want to have favor before your eyes. And I ask you today to show me your glory. Please, Lord, show me your glory. In your name I pray, amen. Father, I pray right now, Lord, that you will reveal your glory to my brother, to my sister watching this program. Lord, I pray that you will make your goodness pass before their eyes and that you will declare to them your name, that you will transform them by your power into your image. And to you, Jesus, be the glory, the honor, and the praise. Amen. If this program has been a blessing to you, if this episode has been a blessing to you, if the Lord has touched you with His glory, with His power, we want to hear from you. If you have a need, and you want God to supply that need, the Bible says, my God will supply all of your needs according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. We want to hear from you. You can write us and send us your prayer request and your testimony of what God is doing in your life. We would love to hear from you. You can contact us through our website, holyspirit.tv. Social media is such a powerful tool that we can use for the glory of God. So I want to encourage you to share this episode through Facebook, through Twitter, through Google+, so that others may encounter the heart of Jesus. If you would like to receive more episodes of this program to your email from different places in Israel, also different clips and videos of testimonies of the power of God from the nations, you can click on subscribe and we will send you these videos through your email. What a blessing it has been to be with you today. It's been such an honor and such an experience for us to be here on top of this mountain. And we want to thank from the bottom of our hearts, all of our partners, all those people who are supporting us, who are standing with us, who believe in this ministry and love this ministry. In appreciation for their support, we want to give to them a free book that I've written about the person of the Holy Spirit and how you can have fellowship and communion and intimacy with the Holy Spirit and how you can be used by His power to be a witness of Jesus, to heal the sick and deliver the oppressed. If you would like more information, you can also visit our website, holyspirit.tv. From right here, from the top of the Mount of Transfiguration, we want to tell you that you can trust in the Holy Spirit, that God loves you, that He wants to reveal His glory to you, to seek Him with all of your heart, and you will find Him. Jesus came to Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel." Welcome to the Mount of Beatitudes.